What's the number one stock market setup that you can use to predict the biggest long-term gainers and even anticipate shorter-term swings that can grow your portfolio at a rate faster than almost any other, you know, news reporter or financial indicator or anything else like that? That's the question with the best setup ever. Now, this setup and this strategy and this technique is not something that just comes out of thin air. It's not something that you can just pull out of nowhere. It actually started a long, long time ago, and I was learning to start investing. And, you know, I remember I was showing my book to one of the leading finance professors at the University of Georgia. And we were, you know, working through what she was teaching, sort of her fourth year graduate finance students. And what was interesting is that those students who are on like their final year of school, final year of college, in the deepest learning environment for finance that they had access to, we're not even learning what this one setup is, this one strategy that has predicted the rise of some of the largest companies in America and is not even taught in schools. And that's why I'm really, really excited, because where this comes from is not like an easy way. This is really a strategy that's originated from, you know, over six figures of losses, trading, thousands and thousands of setups, trying to figure out which one actually, you know, works and which strategy is actually create sort of reliable success and work in predicting sort of actual movements in financial instruments. So the first thing you want to look at when you're thinking about this setup, we're going to call it the A, B, C, D setup, is you want to have an initial run-up, right? So this initial run-up, you have any kind of financial instrument, it goes up, it goes bam, and that initial run-up is awesome. You know, if you bought it already and you're already in it, like, that's great. But for most of the investments you make, sometimes difficult to get in before the big run-up. Sometimes difficult to get in before the big growth curve. And so a lot of times you'll have this big run-up and you're not necessarily in it yet, but this is sort of what gets an investment. It's what gets a stock on everybody's mind, on everyone, right in front of everybody. And after you have it, you have an initial downturn, right? So you want to have a definite peak so it doesn't just go up forever and ever and ever. It's got to have a definite peak. And this is what we call the A, right? So this is the first move of the position and it's the big A, right? And so after the A, you want to see consolidation. Now, for shorter term positions, you really don't want it to drop much below around the 50% of this part. So if you've got like this height right here, for shorter term positions, you really don't want to see it go kind of below halfway. Now, for longer term positions, you can really kind of work it either way. You can go down a lot more and still have good growth potential if the fundamentals are behind it. But in terms of pure technicals, with this position, most of the time you want to see some kind of rebound here. And that is going to be the B, right? So you got your A, and then you have your B, where it has sort of this consolidation. It goes down again, but then it comes back up. And that's sort of the B. And that's really important, because once you have the B, you start to move on to the next step. And this is the most important part of the setup. This is a period of prolonged consolidation. And this is called the C. Now, the C can be short, and the C can be very, very long. I've seen positions where the C is, you know, 38 seconds, and I've seen positions where the C is 38 months. So this works, you know, short term, long term, either way. It just depends on sort of, you just want to have this big A and then the B, and then the C is really where you start to have this position become a reality, where it starts to actually validate itself. And then you have sort of the magic point where the stock goes through the C, and then it hits the previous high, right? And it makes a new high. Now, sometimes this is an all-time high for a bigger, longer-term position. Sometimes this is sort of a shorter-term high, but it doesn't matter, right? All you want is that it goes above where the A was in terms of the initial run-up, right? So as long as it goes above the A and it breaks out, that is your breakout point. That is where you want to get in, right? So you want to buy right around when it hits the new high, and that's what the D is, right? That's where you have the D. Now, in terms of like how you should position it, it's actually fairly, fairly simple. So you take this initial run-up of the A, and you take a calculator, right? Say this is 10 bucks, say this is 8 bucks, okay? Subtract 8 from 10, and you get $2, right? So you take 10, you add 2 to it, and that's going to be your price target, especially in the short term. So here's your conservative entry at the previous high. And if you get a little bit more aggressive with it, you can get in at the C, sort of towards the end of the C, a little bit before it makes a new high. You can have a little bit more upside, a little bit more risk, And it works really, really, really well, because what happens is you have sort of this initial price level where the B is. Now, sometimes with a longer term investment, this is going to be a little bit lower. It might be a little bit closer to the bottom of the A if it takes a while, if it takes a long, 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 long time to get this high. But really, most of the time, you're going to see a support right around the bottom of the B, and you can just set your stop loss there. So if it goes down and it, you know, it doesn't work, then, you know, you're out of the trade, no harm, no foul. And then what this does is it makes you about 90 to 95% of the time, you have at least a 1 to 3 risk reward ratio. So you risk $1,000 for the chance to make $3,000. And what you do is you have a stop loss here, right? So say this is like a 10 grand position, something like that. You're risking $1,000 to make $3,000. So you can make this trade and you can be wrong 66% of the time or more sometimes. And even if you're wrong a majority of the time, you're still going to make a lot of money, because you make three times more than you're risking generally on any given position, 2.5-3 times on the short-term investments. And on longer-term investments, that ratio goes up a ton. It's usually somewhere around the balance of like 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 times the reward potential for what you're risking. But for as a basic general rule, you just take the height of the A and you add it on top of the peak, and that's sort of where you want your target to be for the D. And a bulk of the time, that's where you're gonna buy, kind of around here, and then sell when you get to there, at least sell a majority of the position there.